Blackstone Minerals is Scott Williamson. Scott, welcome back. Good morning.
Good morning, Andrew.
You've had some news recently here, confirmation of high-grade massive sulphides at King's Snake. You say some of the highest intersections you've achieved to date at Blackstone.
Yeah, it's some great numbers in that initial maiden drill holes from King Snake. So the broader zone on hole two is running around 6 meters wide. It's obviously got a lot of nickel in there, but what's interesting is we've got very strong platinum plus palladium plus gold. So around 5 grams per ton over that broader intercept. So yeah, it's a significant byproduct credit in those PGE numbers. And then, but the nickel is still over half of the value of that intercept is still in the nickel as well. So on a gold equivalent basis, we're running around 10 grams per ton on a gold equivalent. So that's a great intercept in anyone's language. And yeah, we're pretty excited about what King Snake might look like. We've got around a dozen holes pending and so plenty more to come on that King Snake zone.
And you're still drilling at King Snake, are you?
Yeah, still 2 drill rigs at the moment on King Snake. We've got around 10 drill rigs, so it's always hard to keep track of them all. But I think at least 2 on King Snake, maybe even 3. But yeah, it's definitely one of our high priority targets we want to drill out as quickly as possible so we can bring it into our study work.
You're clearly encouraged by how King Snake is shaping up. Were you a bit surprised by the market response to these assays?
Yeah, it's been interesting response. It opened strong and then we've been a little bit weaker, but maybe that's the macro environment. But yeah, a little bit surprised. We're pretty excited about what King Snake could look like and is looking and shaping up to be. A little bit confused, but that's fine. That's markets.
You've had some additional assays in too from Ban Chang, have you?
Yeah, Ban Chang's still ongoing and that's in that drill out phase. So that'll be our first resource and we're getting close to finishing the drill out phase on Ban Chang. So continuing to get good numbers there. I mean, we've got 2 zones. We've got the east and the west Ban Chang. We've completed the east zone. We're about to finalize the west zone. So yeah, we're aggressively working towards a maiden resource on Ban Chang.
We didn't speak at the time, Scott, but tell us a bit more about this the Taipan discovery.
Yeah, Taipan's an interesting one. It's in that Ta Khoa target. So Ta Khoa, we went to the main zone at Ta Khoa and that gave us some okay numbers. But when we stepped out to this new zone and it's now the Taipan discovery zone. And that's looking really interesting. Big, broad intercepts from surface. So very shallow, high grade, massive sulfide blended in with lots of disseminated and semi-massive. So yeah, some really interesting stuff coming out of that Taipan discovery zone at Ta Khoa.
And you've got some follow-up work planned for here too, have you?
Yeah, we've still got plenty of drilling to go there. So that we're just stepping down plunge at that Taipan discovery zone. So yeah, drilling ongoing. Yeah, plenty of drill rigs. So yeah, these are the priority targets at the moment, Taipan and King Snake.
You mentioned a moment ago about the macro picture. We're seeing a bit of action in the nickel space at the moment. Where's it tracking, Scott? What's your assessment?
Yeah, it's interesting. We've obviously, the price has come back a little bit because of the Tsingshan announcement. We're confident that the future of nickel needs to be green. If you're supplying battery grade nickel into the electric vehicle market, you want to be focused on those European and US OEMs that are going to require green nickel. So we're confident our product is much superior to what they're talking about in Indonesia. And we're confident that the medium to long-term outlook's very strong for nickel. So yeah, it's okay to cool it down a little bit. It's always good to reset our expectations, but yeah, nickel price, medium to long-term, much higher than today's levels.
And from a near-term news perspective, what can we expect to hear from you?
Yeah, continuing to drill out that King Snake and the Taipan discovery, maiden resource on Ban Chang, we'll try and bring that in as quickly as possible. We're going to put out a study update as well, just to show the market where we're tracking on all those different studies. So we've got a downstream, we've got an upstream component to that study work. So we'll do an update on that very soon. Yeah, so it's just aggressive drilling, lots of exploration excitement. But most importantly, it's about just, I suppose, focusing the market on this downstream opportunity as well. So We're increasing the size of the refinery because of the strong demand coming from the lithium-ion battery industry. So yeah, keep an eye out for those announcements on the downstream, because that's where the real money is going to be made. And the upstream, obviously exciting, but yeah, the downstream is scalable. It's a much larger scale than the upstream. And so yeah, keep an eye on the downstream announcements to come.
And do you reckon that's the secret here to unlocking some upward movement for the share price?
Yeah, I think once the market realizes what we're doing with this downstream strategy, I think that's the moment where the light bulb moment. Once we bring in a major player like an LG or a Samsung or a POSCO, some of these major players are getting, I suppose, more urgent around their need for and security of supply of nickel. So yeah, we'll bring one in or two, who knows, but it'll be a big moment for the company when we do.
And those discussions are going well, Scott, are they?
Yeah, ongoing discussions. And interestingly, the discussions are now turning towards green nickel as well. So it's not just about security of supply on nickel, it's green nickel and focusing on a green outcome for those OEM car manufacturers.
Appreciate the update. As always, Scott, thanks very much.
Thanks, Andrew.